I'm Bridget Green.
And I'm Kevin Weber.
And today we're bringing up AMD at CES 2020.
And
Dr. Lisa Su.
So good to have you here, finally.
I heard you want to talk about technology. You don't have to twist my arm too hard on that topic.
I have hot gossip.
Bring up. Bridget. She's dead. You may not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our very special Vegas edition of The Bring Up.
Yeah, it's really hard to believe that it was just a year ago that we were sitting in this very same AMD demo space. Mm-hmm. We got to see our little first taste of 7-nanometer technology, first little morsel. And now we've got over 20 products that are either in development or in production, all using 7-nanometer technology, and we're just drowning in this stuff.
It's very cool to see.
Too much.
We definitely want to go into some highlights from AMD's CES press conference a little later in the show, but I do not want to bury the lead here, people. No. If you've watched the show before, you know that it has been our quest, nay, our destiny, to have Dr. Lisa Su here on the show. But we've been waiting to get 5,000 likes on an episode because I guess we arbitrarily decided that at some point.
Yeah, because we like making things hard on ourselves.
Pushing ourselves.
That's a better way
and
to put it.
And you know what? We did it. We posted our holiday episode on Instagram, which is something we hadn't done before.
Nope.
And we got those 5,000 likes. We hit the Dr. Lisa Su jackpot.
Yeah, who'd have thought Instagram was going to be our savior? Thanks, Instagram.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, and as it so happened, we got to sit down with Dr. Lisa Su and have a great interview. And actually, it couldn't have been a better opportunity to do it with these big CES announcements.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. So, without further ado,
Dr. Lisa Su. Well, Lisa, we are super excited to have you here. And I think now is probably as good a time as any to finally admit that we did actually just make this entire show so that one day we could sit down and have an interview with you, so.
You got us.
Oh, come on, you had Mark and Forrest. I was wondering, when were you gonna invite me?
No, anytime it was just step after step, and all the way up to Lisa.
It's great to be here.
We are in the heart of CES, and at the press conference, you shared a mission for AMD to deliver the best for gamers and creators in 2020, which is a pretty big New Year's resolution. Can you talk a little about how we're gonna accomplish that?
Well, you know, look, it's been a great CES, as always. We love coming to CES in January and really kicking off the year. And, you know, we are all about bringing the best technology we can to the market. So we're very excited about 2020. You know, we started first with the announcement of the Ryzen 4000 series for mobile. So really exciting. And, you know, you would think 2019 was a big, big desktop year. 2020 is just a huge laptop year. And we're very excited about the new platforms, you know, tremendous performance for ultra thins, gamers, you know, with the H series as well as commercial. So very excited about that. Of course, very excited about the RX 5600 XT, right? I mean, you know, we have such a huge audience that loves Radeon. And so bringing, you know, a really, really great card to the market for 1080p gamers to complete the 55, 56, and 5700 series. You know, those were some of the things. So very exciting.
Yeah.
Well, we can't skip over the announcement of the Threadripper 3990X, which has 64 cores and 128 threads. Other than the two people you're looking at right now who are both very excited for their own personal workflows, the benefits there, who do you think is going to benefit most from having 64 cores?
That was a pretty cool announcement, don't you think?
Yes, it was fantastic.
With the bars?
The bar was great.
Well, look, here's the thing. When you think about what you can do with computing. I mean, if you think just a few years ago, you know, 16 cores seemed like more than you ever needed. But then we did, you know, Threadripper, and we went up to 32 cores. And we said with third gen, you know, why not? Why not go up to 64 cores? And it's not just about technology for technology's sake. It's really about how do we put technology in the hands of power users so that they can do new and important and creative things, right? Like big theme for CES is 8K. And when are we gonna see 8K TVs? By the way, they're gorgeous, but they're only, you know, important if you have the right content. And using you know, the Threadripper, we can really, really change the way content is created. And I'm also really excited about what you can do in you know, really development environments. Like if you're a software developer and you're trying to, you know, create these large applications or you're doing anything with large data sets, the 64-core Threadripper, as well as the entire, you know, Threadripper line is really made to push the envelope. And so, yeah, it's a really fun product. And I know people are excited to see it on shelf in early February, and we're very excited as well.
Yeah, actually, my birthday is February 6th, so coming out February 7th. I feel like maybe I treat myself a little bit.
You knew we had to choose February 7th, right? It's a 7-day, right? Last so seven is very special. Yeah. So
So for a lot of the consumers that are, you know, staying tuned to the news of CES, these announcements are the first time they're hearing about these things. But you have a really unique perspective being involved with these products from the point they're just an idea on a piece of paper, through production, all the way to announcements. So just curious if you can talk a little about what that journey is like for the product, you being involved with it.
Yeah, you know, I have to say, product development is definitely the most fun part of my job. And, you know, you get to start with, you know, ideas. You know, the engineering team comes and shows us concepts of, hey, what should, you know, the next generation desktop look like 3 years from now? Or what should the next server look like? Or the next graphics, you know, technology look like? And then they go into design and, you know, they give me regular updates in design. But once we start and get silicon, like the day we get silicon, you know, we go into daily updates and seeing like, hey, we powered it on and we, you know, ran the first 3D Mark run and we ran the, you know, real applications. That's when it gets really fun.
Yeah.
But of course, launching is also fun. So we love to talk about our products. And I think that it's really a journey. And to see, you know, products like Ryzen and Epic and our Navi products come to life is really the most fun part of my job.
For us too.
So when you started your engineering career at MIT, did you expect that someday you would be working on and presenting the world's fastest processor and the world's most powerful supercomputer?
Interesting question. I have to say, when I started, the first silicon wafers I worked on were 2-inch wafers. All right? They were pretty darn small.
Yeah.
But what was so amazing about it is you could put so much capability in, you know, a small chip. And now, you know, what we're talking about is, you know, putting like tens of billions of transistors on these chips. So, you know, I guess I consider myself really lucky because, you know, we've really been in a place where there's been just a tremendous amount of innovation and advances in semiconductors. And, you know, being at AMD and being, you know, leading the charge on pushing the envelope is really just a great thing to do.
It's crazy to think where it will go, for sure. So AMD obviously has a very passionate fan base, but you also have a very passionate fan base from all the memes we see on Reddit and tweets, and there's certainly nothing more our audience has asked for than to have you on the show.
Oh, thank you.
Curious how you like to best engage with our community and if there's any interactions that stand out for you.
Well, look, our community is just wonderful. And I think most of the community knows that I lurk. So I am a lurker. So whether you're on Reddit or you're on Twitter, you should know that Lisa's probably read that. And the reason I think it's really important, frankly, is direct feedback from our users helps make our product better. And I'm all about making the products better. And, you know, sometimes when you hear directly, you know, we've done things differently. Like, you know, we get a lot of feedback on our drivers. And look, I appreciate that feedback.
Yeah.
It's sometimes it's harsh feedback, but it's good feedback for us. I also love the fact that, you know, people show us all the rigs that they build,
mm-hmm.
right? Some of them are really, really cool. But I must say, my favorite interaction may have been at E3 last year. When I got the little superhero.
Oh my gosh, you know we have one?
Do you have one?
We had
How
one.
Do you have one?
Well,
it's
listen,
mine.
We have our ways, Lisa. It was too cool. We have one on our set, actually.
I'm telling you, superhero sits on my desk at
oh,
home.
Oh, really?
It like watches me as I'm like, you know, doing email at night and stuff. I mean, it is like, it's like a friend.
I mean, I read all of our YouTube comments too, for better or for worse. And
no,
so.
No, look, I really, you know, since I know that a bunch of people are watching, I really want to thank our fans for the feedback they give us. You make us better, and we're all about, you know, bringing out the best tech we can. So, really, really happy with our fans, and really happy with all of our all of the feedback that we get.
They're great.
Yeah, so CES is obviously a really exciting way to start the year, and this year is no exception. So when you think about next year and the years to come, what kind of excites you and what are you focused on? I guess the easiest way to ask the question is, Lisa, do you have any hot goss?
Are you looking for secrets?
A little bit.
You know, I said 2020 is going to be a huge year for us, and I'm really, really excited. You know, if you just think about what we've talked about at CES, you know, what we're doing in laptops with the 4000 series and with the Threadripper 64 core and with 5600 XT, you know, my main message to our fans is this is just the beginning for us in 2020. And I've heard a little bit through, you know, Twitter and Reddit that people are wondering about, you know, Big Navi. And, you know, I can say you're going to see Big Navi in 2020.
Awesome.
There might be a few people wondering about Zen 3 as well. And I can tell you Zen 3 is doing really well. We're excited about it.
Exciting.
And I look forward to talking more about that later in 2020.
Okay.
Awesome. We cannot wait to talk about that with you. And can't thank you enough for coming on the show. I know our viewers are going to be ecstatic to see you here. And I guess same time next year.
Sounds good.
We'll be right here.
It's great being here. Thank you.
Thank you. Straight off the CES stage, we'd like to introduce you to the Lenovo YogaSlim 750, the world's thinnest and lightest 8-core x86 laptop with up to 18 hours of battery life starting at just 3 pounds.
And the ASUS Zephyrus G14, the world's most powerful 14-inch gaming laptop with battery life that gets you through up to 11 hours of video playback and a 1440p display.
All this and more brought to you by the AMD Ryzen 4000 series mobile processors coming to you very soon.
We did it. We interviewed Dr. Lisa So.
Yeah, I'm still reeling a little bit, but we have a lot of announcements we still need to cover.
That's right, Kevin. That's right. It's time for our highly anticipated AMD CES Team Red Carpet coverage.
Number 3.
We'll kick it off by senior directing your attention to senior director of RTG, Laura Smith, who swept the stage with the unprecedented announcement of the Radeon RX 5600 XT.
It's a rectangle, it's gray, and it's here to slay. Mm-hmm. 1080p gaming, that is.
As you can see, in Call of Duty Modern Warfare, the 5600 is winning by 10%. In Division 2, we're winning by 15%, and Gears of War 5 is just as strong.
Laura also claimed
2020 is definitely the year of the gamer.
Sounds a lot more fun than the year of the rat.
I'll say.
Number 2.
New to the AMD family, Alienware alumnus Frank Azor sports the classy, elegant ASUS Zephyrus G14.
It's going to have the latest AMD Ryzen 4000 series processors, of course. But the form factor is pretty remarkable. Only 3.5 pounds for all of this performance. Over 10 hours of battery life and a sub 18 millimeter Z height. It's pretty incredible. But probably my favorite feature about this product is what you'll see on the backside.
Now, Kevin, not everyone can pull off an animated LED matrix display, but I gotta tell you, Frank's making it look pretty effortless.
All that and only 3.5 pounds? What's its secret?
Number 1.
The incomparable Dr. Lisa Su steals the show with a gorgeous red stripe that goes all the way across all 3 screens.
What a bold look.
I actually need 3 screens to show you what you can do here.
Big red stripes,
very in. It's certainly not just for show though, because this fabulous bar chart shows the Threadripper 3990X with almost 5 times the performance against our competitor's leading product in the segment.
It's a lot of times, Kevin.
Sure is.
Well, it was an iconic presentation from start to finish, but what else would you expect at this point?
Nothing less.
What a great CES. We've had a wonderful time, and I hope you guys have had a great time watching as well.
Yep, and as always, please be sure to like and subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you make sure you never miss an episode. And if we get to 5,000 likes on this video, we'll have Dr. Oh, well, we already got the 5,000 likes.
We did it.
And what do I say now?
I guess that was kind of like my biggest goal in life.
Yeah, sort of.
And then we did it.
Sort of peaked.
Well, we've already ridden in a gondola ride.
Yep.
We've already hosted a game show.
Yeah.
And then we had that epic VR dance battle.
Yeah, and we taught those six zoo lions how to love.
We do that.
I don't really remember. But what's important is that I think we do have to keep doing the show, because in this episode, we really only covered the few products that are coming out in the next few months. And I think you and I both know that there's still a lot more coming.
Well, you heard it straight from Lisa. Mm-hmm. Lots of exciting things to come.
Yep, for sure. Plus, if any of you have any ideas for topics or guests that you'd love to see on the show, let us know in the comments.
Yes, please do. And for those of you who stuck around to the end of the episode, we have a little special treat. Mm-hmm. You might have noticed the beautiful space that we're filming at here today. This is AMD Space at CES. And crazy thing, doesn't look like this when you show up.
Sure doesn't.
Kind of just looks like a room. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to give a shout out to one of the unsung heroes of these AMD events, the demo team and production crews that turn these spaces into such beautiful places to showcase our technology. Mm-hmm. So take a look at how they transform this space in just a few days. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.